What is this foam? Is it a toxic chemical concoction, lethal to human contact? Or is it just harmless bubbles? I'm at the Bells Rapids, about 30 kilometers northeast of Perth. Each year, hundreds of kayakers take part in the Avon descent, passing through this stretch of water. But should they be worried about plowing through the foam? I've come 50 kilometers downstream to the University of Western Australia. Here, I'm hoping to conduct some chemical analysis to find out what our river foam is made out of. I've brought with me three samples of water. Firstly, we have some tap water. This is going to be our control. Next, we have some water from the Bells Rapids. This is the one with all the foam we care so much about. Finally, I've got some water from just outside on the Swan River. I think it's really strange how the Swan River doesn't have all of the bubbles in it, even though they're technically from the same source. When water goes through the Bells Rapids, it gets churned up. So in order to put them all on the same level playing field, let's shake them up. Even though they were all equally agitated, less bubbles form in our river and tap water samples. This is a total organic carbon analyzer. Scientists use this setup to test for thousands of different chemicals. We begin by taking a small sample of our solution and then placing it into the auto sampler. The sample gets combined with a number of different chemicals. This creates carbon dioxide, which bubbles to the surface. The carbon dioxide gas then goes through two scrubbers. Now, with our pure carbon dioxide, we can put it into the spectrum analyzer. This is what it looks like inside our machine. A special light shines through both tubes. One tube is simply a vacuum, while the other contains our gas. If the photons from our lamp hit a carbon dioxide molecule, then the photon will be absorbed. If the photon hits other types of molecule, no absorption occurs. By comparing the brightness at the ends, we can easily calculate the concentration of carbon in our sample. While we wait for the machine to run, let's try to understand the foaming process. Every drop of water contains trillions of tiny water molecules. Water molecules want to cling together because of very strong bonding between adjacent hydrogen and oxygen atoms. At the surface, there are fewer water molecules to attract, which means that the molecules that do come in contact are much more strongly bonded, which results in a thin film. We know this as surface tension. As you can see, it's strong enough to support a paperclip. In order to create our foam, we need to reduce the surface tension of the water. It's now been 3 weeks and the results are out. As we can clearly see, there is much more dissolved organic carbon in the rapids water than either the river or in the tap. We can even see some of this in the form of the brown coloration of our sample. Much of our dissolved carbon is part of a group of molecules called surfactants, chemical agents that act at the surface of liquids. Soap is part of this group. By adding in just a little bit of soap, the surface tension becomes too weak for the paperclip and it sinks to the bottom. This means the dissolved carbon in our rapids water reduces surface tension, allowing bubbles to be formed. So we know how it works, but how does dissolved organic carbon make its way into the rivers? Well, if you look along the banks as well as in the water itself, you'll find countless living organisms. When these organisms die and decay, the proteins that made up their bodies turn into dissolved organic carbon, much of which acts as surfactants, giving us the foamy bubbles that we can see today. Rather than the stuff of nightmares, this river foam is actually just a naturally occurring process, taking place in almost all rivers and streams. That being said though, I'm still going to be washing my hands pretty well after the shoot. This stuff is disgusting. Massive thank you to UWA's Michael Smirk for helping with the chemical tests and making this video possible. Next up, we launch an exciting new series on Engineering Europe. Make sure to subscribe so as not to miss it. Until then, this has been James Dingley from the Atomic Frontier. Keep looking up. Camera.